हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू इंग्लिश सेशन। लेट्स स्टार्ट आवर समेटिव असेसमेंट टू सेशन एंड वी आर गोइंग टू सी अ फर्स्ट पोयम दैट इज़ यूनिट 5, द सॉलिटरी रीपर एंड इट्स रिटन बाय विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ। सो लेट्स सी व्हाट विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ हैव सेड इन दिस पोयम। About poet and poem, William Wordsworth, born in the 1777th April, and he left this world on 23rd April 1850. He was an English romantic poet who, with Samuel Taylor, Coleridge helped to launch the Romantic Age in English literature with their joint publication, Lyrical Ballads, in the year 1798. Wordsworth was poet from 1843 until his death on 23rd April 1850. So about this poem, The Solitary Reaper is a lyric of English romantic poet William Wordsworth and one of his best known works. The poem was inspired by him and his sister Dorothy's stay at the village of Scotland in September 1803. So he has seen that village in Scotland, and by seeing that situation, he has wrote this poem. So let's look into the glossary, the new words from this poem. So I want you all to repeat these words loudly and understand the word. The first stanza. Behold her, single in the field, yon solitary highland lass, reaping and singing by herself, stop here or gently pass. Alone she cuts and binds the grain, and sings a melancholy strain. Oh listen, for the vale profound is overflowing with the sound. Explanation. Here, the poet, while travelling in the highland valleys, okay, he come across a lonely highlander and he see a reaper girl. Reaper girl is a girl who is harvesting the crops and singing by herself, right? And he tries to draw the attention of the passers by the girl by calling them to behold her. The poet urged them to stop there and listen to her song, or to pass by gently without disturbing her in her singing. The solitary reaper is cutting and binding the grain while singing a sad song. Okay, the poet again urges the others traveler to listen her music, or it's overflowing the deep valley. So it's in simple term we can say, when the poet was traveling, okay, he was about to cross the highland and he heard a sound of a girl, and the girl was in a field, right? And she was harvesting the crop. Right, crops, and she was singing by herself. Okay, and all the passers, what they were doing, whoever is passing from that way, they used to listen to that girl song. Okay, and this poet had called them as a behold her. Okay, and the poet was urging everybody. The poet was requesting everybody to stop there for a while and listen that song which she was singing. Right, and then he also says that she was alone in the field. She was alone in the field. She was cutting the grasses, the harvesting process she was doing, and she was collecting the grains. Okay, and she was all alone in that field, and she was singing a very sad song. That's the reason. Again, the poet again he's trying to tell the travelers to stop to that place and listen to her music, which was overflowing, which was very beautiful song which was she was singing. And the poet wanted the people, the travelers, to stop that place and listen to that song. Second stanza. No nightingale did ever chaunt more welcome notes to weary bands of travelers in some shady haunt among Arabian sand. A voice so thrilling never was heard in springtime from the cuckoo bird, breaking the silence of the seas among the farthest heartbreaks. So you can see a picture on that particular slide. You can see the night angle is there, right? You can see the travelers, right? You can see a travelers there, and even you can see a different kinds of scenery there, right? So let's see, let's go for the explanation. Now here the poet compares the Reaper's girl's song, the girl's song, with that of sweet singing nightingale bird. We know about nightingale bird, right? The nightingale bird sings very sweetly, right? Very marvelously. And here the poet is comparing the Reaper's song, the girl's song, to that sweet singing nightingale song. Okay, and the notes are nothing but the lyrics. Okay, the melodious note of a nightingale sound, sweet and welcome to a tired group of travelers in some shady shelter in the middle of the Arabian desert. As you can see in the picture there, right? You can see a picture here that in a desert is there, right? So the travelers who are passing through the desert areas, or the travelers, right? So when they listen the song of the nightingale, it makes the travelers feel happy. Okay, it makes the travelers to be happy. And the sweet, when the nightingale sing the song, right? That is means the welcoming the travelers. They welcome the travelers where they can sit. So this traveler is nothing but the nightingale used to give them a hint by singing a song. It used to give the hint to the traveler. There's a shady place nearby, so you can come and take rest. But here the poet says the song of the highland girl is far sweeter than that of the nightingale. That means he says this girl sings very sweetly than compared to the nightingale. And now he also compares in the next stanza to the cuckoo. You also heard of the cuckoo, right? So another name for this cuckoo is songbird. Okay, so this cuckoo bird in springtime breaks the silence of the sea. In the far off he breaks the island. But according to the poet, the song of solitary reaper is more thrilling than that of the cuckoo. So now we can see one more picture here, the cuckoo picture right here. Yes, so cuckoo is a voice so thrilling never so heard. Okay, and it's only sing during the springtime, and it breaks the silence of the sea. But here says that this cuckoo bird is also nothing in front to the song of the reaper girl. So this is the explanation for your second stanza. Third stanza. Will no one tell me what she sings? Perhaps the plaintive number flow for old unhappy far off thing and battles long ago. Or is it some more humble lay, familiar matter of today, some natural sorrows, loss or pain that has been and may be again. So you can see a picture there. You can see a picture when they have a battle, right? So all unhappy far things, the battles long ago, and you can see there's a loss. The girl is crying. So maybe in the song, maybe she's expressing her pain or her sorrow or her disturbed mind, which can be come again. So let's see the exact explanation of this stanza. So in this stanza, the poet doesn't comprehend the meaning of song or its subject matter, as a girl is probably singing in her native language. So here the poet is not able to understand exactly what is she singing, because the girl is singing in her native language or her own language, which is difficult for this poet to understand. So he asked the other travelers who is traveling with him, he asked them if anyone can throw some light on what she's singing. So he's asking the other travelers if anyone know what she's singing. So can you please tell me what exactly the lyrics? Okay, but from its tone, the poet says, I'm not able to understand the lyrics, the word, but definitely with her tone I can understand something. What he can understand, he says, he guessed it to be a mournful song. Mournful song is sad song. Okay, about some old unhappy things or past battle. So in that poem, in that song which is sang by that girl, he's not able to understand the words which she's using in the song, but he understands through the tone, okay, the music, that she is singing a song which is a very sad song, or maybe she's telling something about old unhappy things or some past problems or past battle which you can be seen in that particular poem. And again, Wordsmith guesses that the song might be about some more usual happenings, like some natural sorrow. So he's just guessing. Maybe that song is about some natural sorrows or loss or pain, right? Or a death of somebody in her family, or something happening to day-to-day life, right? Incidents. So maybe this is the song which she's singing, which can happen again also. Maybe it happened in the past, but maybe it will happen also in present or in future. That is how he has guessed about the song, that the song is not a good song, but she's very sad about something, and that is why she is singing this sad song or mournful song. The last stanza. Whatever the theme, the maiden sang as if her song could have no ending. I saw her singing at her work, and over the sickle bending, I listened, motionless and still. And as I mounted up the hill, the music in my heart I bore, long after it was heard no more. So in the picture you can see a girl is singing and doing her work, and she has one sickle. Sickle is a knife. And he was like motionless. You can see in a picture the one man is standing, so assume it's a poet. He's standing motionless without moving and is listening to her song. So now in this stanza, the Solitary Reaper poem, Wordsmith talks about the impact the Reaper song left upon his mind. Now he's in the last stanza, he's telling that how hardly it has been fixed to his mind, right? How it has been into his mind. He says, no matter what the theme was, he says, I don't know what the theme was. Maybe it's a sad song, maybe it's a happy song, but he has guessed it was a sad song. So he says, no matter what the theme was, the maiden girl, the girl was singing like there is no stopping. So she was keep on singing that song, and he was guessing like it has no ending. It has no ending, and she's not going to stop. Our poet saw her singing at her work, bending over her, and the poet saw the girl was keep on singing the song, and while she's doing work also, right? She has one sickle in her hand, and she's bending, and she was singing the song, and she's not stopping that song. And the flow of her music was so impressive that it seemed to never ending. So when she was singing, the flow of music was so beautiful, so impressive, that this he came to know that she's not going to stop the song. And then the poem listened to the girl's song, right? He was listening to girl's song. He stopped on his way and stood still, and he was very much charmed by the girl's beautiful song. Okay, and so when he was continuing his traveling, when he was climbing up the hill, the song could no longer be heard from there. So when he was going far from that girl's field, or when the girl was standing and singing, when he was climbing up, when he was going far, he couldn't heard the song of the girl, okay? But he had that music in his mind. It has a beautiful music in his mind, and he was able to hum that song, right? Humming, we say humming, right? Right? Maybe sung song which you don't know the lyrics, but you still hum it, right? So you just keep on saying the humming, and the melody of Solitary Reaper song in his heart. The music was so beautiful that it was in his mind, and also it was in his heart, and it was such an impression of the song upon his mind. So he had a beautiful that he heard a beautiful song which is sang by this beautiful lady who was working in a field, and that is how he loved the song, and he bore the music in his mind, and it was there in his heart for a long time, because it was a very impressive song which he heard recently. So I hope you have understood this poem. So I want you all to make a video of this poem while reciting this poem. And if you have any doubts, please ask me. Thank you. Have a good day.